The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. 13th chapter, text number 1 and 2. Given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on December 29th, 1972, in Bombay, India.
Arjuna said, O my dear Krishna, I wish to know about Prakriti, nature, Purusha, or the enjoyer, and the field, and the knower of the field, that is knowledge, and the end of knowledge. The blessed Lord then said, This body, O son of Kunti, is called the field, and one who knows this body, is called the knower of the field.
Khetra, khetra, gya. Just like we are living in this apartment, and we know that I am not this apartment, but I am living in this apartment. The people say that because the super soul or the soul is living within this body, therefore the body is soul. This is not very good argument. That is being cleared by Krishna himself. Idam sariram kaunteya khetra iti abhidhyate. Khetra. Khetra means a land or a place. So, idam sariram kaunteya khetram iti abhidhyate. And the next
one.
Etavya veti. And one who knows it, he is khetra go. Go means in knowledge. So, we should know this, that I am not this body. It is my body. If we analyze the body, I say it is my hand, it is my leg, it is my head. Nobody says I head or I hand. I is different from this body. I am living in this apartment, but I am not this apartment. But the modern civilization is going on the basic idea that I am this body. I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahman, I am Kshatriya, I am man, I am woman. This is condemned. This is the conception of the animal. The animal, they do not know that the dog, the body dog, and the soul who has obtained the body of a dog, the soul is different from the body. This is the basic information. Asangayam purusha. The living entity, soul, is not this material body. He has no association. He is put into that condition, but he is different from the body. What is that? She has gone out and cannot come. So this should be clearly understood. This is knowledge. That I am not this body. What is the name? Second line? Yes, next. Etadya Vethi. So, if you study, if you meditate on our body, I am this body, I am this finger, no, the answer will come. No, I am not this body. It is my body. It is my finger. It is my head. This is a simple thing. And here it is confirmed by the Supreme Authority, Krishna. And we can experiment it. So how it is that I am identifying myself in this body. Therefore, Shastra says, Jashyatu buddhi kunape siddhatuke. This body is a product of the three dhatu, according to Ayurvedic system, kapha, pitta, vayu. So, anyone who is accepting this body made of three elements, kapha, pitta, vayu, he is no better than gokhara, saiva gokhara. Jasyatubuddhi kunapi tidhasake sadhik kalatra disubhomayadhi jati sabuddhi salile nakarhiche janesu avignesu saiva gokhara. Gokhara, go means cow and khara means ass. So people are identifying with this body. But Shastra says such persons are no better than the cows and the asses. Now just try to understand what is this civilization. Just try to understand it is a combination of cows and asses. Because everyone is identifying, I am this body. I am America, I am Russia, I am China. Let us fight. I am Hindu, I am Muslim. This is going on. The simple knowledge is lacking. The simple knowledge that I am not this body. I am aham brahmasmi. The basic language. Soham. Soham means I am the same spirit soul as the super soul, as Krishna. I am qualitatively one. As Krishna is Sachidananda Vigraha, similarly, I am also Sachidananda, part and parcel. The difference is that I am very minute. As we have sometimes explained, the minute particle of gold is also gold. That is not different. A minute drop of the sea water is also the same quality, the same chemicals. Similarly, we being part and parcel of Krishna, we are not subjected to the material condition, but we have put ourselves in this material condition. That is called Maya. We wanted to enjoy separately, separated from Krishna, and therefore we are put into a condition which is illusion. That I have already explained several times. At night we forget all this body. Although in daytime I identify myself that I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahman. At night when I sleep I forget whether I am American, Indian, or Brahman, or Kshatriya. This is our daily experience. I am in a different atmosphere. I am dreaming something. And again, at this time, I forget what I dreamt at night. Sometimes we go very unknown place, very nice place, very nice building, light atmosphere. As soon as the dream is over, then again I am on my bed. And when I dream, I forget I am not in my bed, but I am in the surrounding of palaces, of gardens. So this is our daily experience. Because we wanted to imitate Krishna, Krishna Bhuliyaji Bhagavan Sakare, the Krishna has given us a place which is illusion. Which is not fact, temporary, illusion. Just like we sometimes see water in the desert. That is illusion. Practically there is no illusion and there is no water. But we see, oh, here is water, vast water. The animals, they run after the water. Similarly, we are also running after this illusion. There is happiness. There is happiness. But there is no happiness. At the fag end of life, we are disappointed, we are frustrated. Vidhya kalo avalo sabasukha bhavalo. When we cannot again, no more, we can enjoy with our senses, then we become very much depressed. Old men, you will find old men, those who are not spiritually inclined, they are very morose. Morose because they cannot use anymore the senses. They sometimes take medicine. But how can we do? So, vriddha kala avala. So we are under this illusion. This is called maya. We should understand that we are not this body. We are not this body. Our bodily enjoyment, sense gratification, that is illusion. In another place in the Bhagavad Gita, you will find it is said, sukham mattam sikam jastat otindriya grahya. Find out that word. Sukham attam sikam jastat otindriya grahya. We are trying to enjoy life with these material senses, but that is illusion, that is temporary. Temporary and illusion. Real enjoyment is with our spiritual senses. What is it? Have you got?
Sukham attam jastat buddhi grahyam atindriyam deti yatrana chayavayam.
What is the translation?
There's a few verses together. The stage of perfection is called trance or samadhi. When one's mind is completely restrained from material mental activities by practice of yoga. This is characterized by one's ability to see the self by the pure mind and to relish and rejoice in the self. In that joyous state, one is situated in boundless transcendental happiness and enjoys himself through transcendental senses. Established thus, one never departs from the truth, and upon gaining this, he thinks there is no greater gain.
So, every information is there. If we want actually happiness, then we have to purify the material consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness movement. We have come to the point of Krishna consciousness. That Krishna consciousness can be achieved by the grace of Krishna. Krishna consciousness, athati te devo padam mujadvam prasada leshanu grihita evai. Krishna cannot be understood by any other method than the Krishna method. Krishna is absolute. Therefore, if one wants to understand Krishna, he must take the Krishna method. Krishna method. Because Krishna is absolute, there is no difference between Krishna and the method of attaining Krishna. They are the same. Method, the bhakti method means Krishna method. Bhakta Bhagavan. And the method to approach Bhagavan is called bhakti. The whole thing is based on one root, bhaj. Bhajadhatu. Bhajadhatu, that means offering a loving service to the Lord. And Krishna says, bhaktya mama vijanati. Anarbhajati mamanannava. These words are there. Sadhuriva samantabha. Apite sukracharo bhajati mamanannava. Bhajati, this means bhajati. Chatudgira bhajati ma. This word bhaja is very important. From bhaja, the word bhakti comes. Bhajada Sukti. So, bhakti means bhajan. Bhajati Mahavananda. Mahatmanusya maham prastha dvaivi prakriti maastita. Bhajanti anandamani. So, again bhajanti. Mahatmanusya maham prastha dvaivi prakriti maastita. This bhajan is for mahatmas, not for the duratmas or kudratmas. Mahatma, one whose atma has been expanded. Mahatma, not crippled. Those who are thinking in terms of society, nationality, country, religion, or so many things, they are not mahatma. They are kudratmas. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He says, Prithivite ashe jato nagaradigya. He is not thinking in terms of Prithivite ashe jato nagaradigya. As many towns and villages are there all over the world. He is not thinking in terms of my village, my country, my society. Everyone is thinking like that. But those who are Mahatma actually, they are thinking in a broader way. Prithivi Tayasidhatu Nagara. Krishna is thinking in terms of all living entities. Sarvajoni Shukamunte, Sambhavanti Murta. All living entities, in all species of life, in all forms of life. Aham Bija Pradapita, I am their father. So, this is called Mahatma. Krishna is thinking in terms of our limits. People are saying that Krishna is Hindu God. Oh, why Hindu God? In the dictionary, it is said, in English dictionary, that Krishna is one Hindu God, is not? Why Hindu God? He says that I am the father of all living entities. Why he should be the father of the Hindus? Indians. His father of everyone. He says, but they write in the dictionary, Krishna is Hindu God. Misinterpretation. Krishna doesn't say. And Krishna himself, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Prithivi Tayase Jato Nagara Adhigya. As many villages and towns are there, Sarvatra Prachar Hoye Mono. That my name will be celebrated in every village, every town. So this Krishna consciousness movement is not a crippled movement. It is a very broad movement, claiming all living entities to come to Krishna, back to home, back to Godhead. Therefore, we should not be bodily conscious. Krishna here says, the body is not I am this body. Idam sariram khetram. It is a field of activities. Khetram. Field of activities. Just like one who is bodily conscious, he undergoes very severe exercises. The body becomes very stout and strong and he is happy. He is happy. Because he thinks on this body. Similarly, you can make your body spiritually strong. As you make your body materially strong, similarly you can make your body, because this is khetra. Khetra means the field or the land. In the land, by tilling the land, by cultivating the land, you can produce nice grain also and inferior grain also as you walk, because the land is in your possession. You can cultivate as you like. Similarly, this body is land and I am the tiller. I am the krishak or agriculturist. So, by using the land, I can become spiritually advanced or I can become materially advanced. It is up to me. Spiritually advanced means gradually you forget that I am this material body, I am Krishna, I am Brahma, that is spiritually advanced. And material advanced means I am this body, I am American, I am Indian, I am Brahman, I am Kshatriya, I am man, I am man. This is material. Both ways. This human form of life, because it is not animal life. Always remember that I am not animal, I am now human being. So, I can utilize, these things will be explained in this chapter, how I can utilize this body. Both ways I can utilize. If I simply limit myself with the bodily necessities of life, just like the animals, eating, sleeping, sex intercourse, and defense, these are common to the human body and the cats and dogs' body. But because I am a human being, I can utilize my body in a different way. The cats and dogs cannot do. That is the difference between a human being and an animal. If you don't utilize my body as human being, then I am no better than cats and dogs. Actually, I am cats and dogs. If you simply limit myself, how to eat very nicely, how to sleep very nicely, how to have sex intercourse very nicely, and how to defend myself very nicely, then you are no better than animal. But this is the business of the animal. The animal cannot be invited to become Krishna conscious. That is not possible. Even if he is invited, he cannot sit down, he cannot hear. Therefore, those who are very much advanced in animal propensities, they cannot take part in this Krishna consciousness movement. Those who are, to say frankly, no better than animals, they cannot take any interest in the Krishna consciousness movement. That is not possible. Therefore Krishna says, who can take? He says, we take from Krishna all the world, you don't believe me. Krishna says that jesam antagatam papam janānam punyakarmānam te dhannamaha nirmukta bhajanti māng dhirabhrata. So, animal life means sinful life. Animal life. Even this human form of life is also sinful unless we come to the Krishna consciousness platform. We come to the animal life means sinful life. If I act as sinful, as hogs and dogs, just like if I don't discriminate from eating, just like the hogs, they have no discrimination. They accept even stool. Come on, I shall eat. They get the body of hog or dog. And if you utilize this body according to the Shastra to purify it, because human body is meant for purification. Jasma suddheta satya. That is given the instruction given by Vishwamitra. Tapo dibbam putraka jasma suddheta satya jena suddheta satya jasma brahma sukham anantam. Nayang deha dehu bhajang niloke kastan kaman arhativir bhujanavi. He advised, respected his sons, my dear sons, don't use this body like the hogs and dogs. Whole day and night searching after stool, eating, for eating. don't use it. And after eating, as soon as there is the sex is strong, then sex life, there is hog life. You have seen. These are the examples, natures. They are very soft and strong, fatty. The eating is too. And as soon as fatty, immediately sex life, without any discrimination, mother, sister, or anyone. There is hog. You see, from nature's example, dogs and hogs, the dog has no caste seed or shame at and then display they are having sex life. So human civilization is coming to that. Already it has come. In Western countries, at least in our country it has not come still. And Western is common affair. Young man, young woman is embracing, kissing and everything. And sometimes sexually also engaged on the sea beach in the garden. We have seen it. So practically you are coming to the hogs and dogs life. This is our advancement actually. Why? On account of this bodily concept of I am this body. So, this should be first of all understood as Krishna said. Idam shariram kaunteya kshetram. It has been awarded to you for utilizing it for different purposes as you like. You can utilize it like cats and dogs and hogs, and you can utilize it as devata, as demigods. That is up to you. We have got little independence. We can utilize or misuse this independence. But the Shastra says that this body is not to be utilized as cats and dogs and hogs. Shastra. Therefore, Krishna says, Jashastra vidhim usrijya vartate kamakala. Anyone who does not care for the instruction given in the Shastra, Shastra just like anyone who doesn't care for the law of the state, what kind of man he is? He is a loafer, the outlaw, he is not a respectable citizen. Similarly, anyone who does not follow the Shastra, in Shastra as meant for human beings, not for the cats and dogs and hogs, as law is meant for the human being, not for the cats and dogs. Therefore, you have to follow the Shastra in Shastra. Thank you very much. That's all.